James Blunt and your beautiful on BBC Radio Cumbria. So we've moved to the back of the studio now, where I'm faced with a plant, some twigs, and a pair of shears. Go on then. What's happening?
Tense, nervous laughter again. Right, what we're going to do is just a quick rule of thumb pruning for dogwoods, which is the brightly coloured sticks in front of you. Grown for its brightly coloured sticks, well planted by the council, they grow in pinks and reds and greens. Good, easy maintenance, dead easy plant to grow. Will take a bit of damp in the garden and everything. All you're going to do is you're growing it for the sticks, so we want to get as many sticks as we can for next winter. If we leave it as it is, all it's going to do is put more leaves on, not a lot of growth. What I want you to do, he's laughing again, is reduce it to about 6 inches above where it was cut last year. You can see where the joint is from last year.
Now that is basically just a stub, really, isn't it?
Yeah, that's where it was cut last year, and you can see what's happened. It's divided into two. So every time you cut it this year, you're going to hopefully get two new strong branches. So basically, you're going to double up on everything. So what I want you to do is 6 inches above there, pick out a bud, a couple of buds. You can see where they are there, the little nodules in the branch, and just prune above that. It wants to be about 5 millimetres above and slightly slanting so the rain runs off the joint.
You see, this is so technical, I wouldn't have even thought about being slightly slanting for the rain.
It's not technical, it's just clever when you think about it. It's common sense, really. The last thing you want to
do... That's technical to me.
What happens is, if you cut it level, the core in the centre of the branch will dry out, creating a little reservoir. The water will sit in there and then rot out the plant.
You see. Tell you, it's an education, you guys coming in here. Okay, now Steve, can I just give you the microphone? There we go, producer Steve. So,
6 inches is roughly the size of your secateurs.
So my secateurs, there. So I'm starting off there. So I'm
you're looking
there.
For a couple of buds.
So I've got a bud there and a bud there.
I go to that one.
So I do it at a slant, at an angle. So there we go, about that. Is that about right there?
Not bad for a beginner.
Is that all right?
Not bad at all.
There we go. So that's one done. So I do the same on another branch. So use the secateurs as a guide, to 6 inches there. So there's my bud. So just, again, at an angle just above that bud, about 5 millimetres. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Okay. There we go. And so that's two. Shall I do one more?
Go on, do this one here. Shall we do the big one at the back?
Okay. So we've got 6 inches from the bud, which is about there. So is that the bud there, Stuart? Yes. Okay. And for the third and final time, there we go.
Now you can do that on buddleias, dogwoods, several other plants in the garden. Roses, if you haven't pruned your roses back in the winter, they will be putting up nice new growth now. If you go back to a nice leaf that's pointing outwards, a bud that's pointing outwards, prune that and you'll get a nice crop of roses this year, hopefully.
We've had a call from Harry, who's in Egremont, who, on the subject of pruning, says, when's the best time to prune Lalandii trees, Nick?
I would be waiting until they're actually starting to actively grow. So you're going to be looking mid-April, probably the earliest, even end of April. And then you need to cut them once then and again towards the end of summer, so about September time. Two cuts a year will keep it under control for you.